Reportando.
Reportando.
Ask Roy Jones.
Huh?
Ask Roy Jones. I want to see what he said.
Who do you think has the fastest hands in boxing, in the history of boxing?
History? I'd say Sugar Ray Leonard.
You say Ali?
Yeah, Muhammad Ali.
Fastest hands in boxing?
Manny Pacquiao.
I knew you would say that. Pacquiao does have fast hands. And fast feet. His feet, I think, are his... Yeah, his footwork.
Yeah.
Let's see it. Coach, let me ask you. Why is it that someone could spend 40 minutes on a treadmill, can hit the back for 12 rounds, but they gas out in sparring after 1 minute?
Nerves.
Think so?
Yeah, you have to learn how to control what's up here and what's here. If you can't help control that, you can go as long. There's a lot of guys coming to the gym that haven't been in the gym for weeks or even months. They get in the ring, go 6-7 rounds. It's all about mental. It's a mental process. You don't know how to control yourself when you do it.
I say that about basketball. If you don't play basketball for 2 years, you can step on the court and you're playing for 2 hours. But in boxing, if you take a month off, it's very hard to have the stamina to do a whole workout.
Oh, well, depending on what that includes, your whole workout, you know. But you're in the goal for 5 or 6 rounds, yeah. I've seen guys come off the street and they can do that. I mean, it's not about anything else doing the bags, they think, but they can do 5 or 6 rounds right off the bat. And then they're on the floor, they hit the bag a little bit, little speed bag. But the main thing is having this. That's me what the biggest thing is, mind control.
Most fighters today train for 2 hours.
Yeah.
When you were in camp with Ali's opponents, whether it was Frazier or whether it was some of the other people you were in camp with?
Yeah. Frazier, Norton.
Norton.
Foreman, I hate to say it, Larry Holmes.
How long did they train? Was it also 1.5 hours, 2 hours, or was it shorter or longer?
They usually, from the time they got there until the time they left, it was about 2.5 to 3 hours.
Same thing like today?
Yeah.
So it that has not changed.
It's all about the intensity of the work that you put in. I mean, you come to work every day. If you don't put no work in, the work is still very shallow. Doesn't extend you. You gotta have something that makes you extend yourself. That makes you kind of reach for something. And if you are kind of getting to the exhausting spot where your mind has come into play, that makes a difference.
What you're saying is don't go through the motions. Don't just mail it in. Don't show up and, I trained today.
That's what
do
that's,
it with a purpose.
A lot of people do that, and I think that's a real fault. People never find out how good they could be. And that's important. When that bell rings, you're gonna try to find out how good you are. And then when you get there, you're testing yourself. That's the wrong place to test yourself.
All right, there you have it. Stan Ward with wise words. EsNewsReporting.com. Melissa Peck reporting.